my introduction of the Casagrandes being the Thanksgiving episode, and it took me a while to watch more episodes after binge-watching The Loud House, I have to admit that the Casagrandes is mostly a mixed bag. Considering that some fans of The Loud House say that this is better than The Loud House, mainly its later seasons, and the fact that the characters themselves are a lot more different compared to the characters from The Loud House, I really feel like this entire spinoff sums up of what they're trying to do with Ronnie Anne. And considering that this episode doesn't center around Ronnie Anne, it's gonna take a while for me to talk about her character. One of the reasons why I'm reviewing this episode V.I.Peeved is most likely the fact that this episode has the same elements from the Loud House episode. Well, the family mostly goes out of control and just this close to embarrassed one of the family members. But then at the end of the day, it ends up becoming a huge miracle for the main character. Granted, that didn't really happen when it comes to the Loud House episodes. Well, Lincoln is trying to prove himself that he doesn't really need meddling from his sisters. But with this, it's mostly the Casagrandes being thrilled to be in backstage before the performance happens. To be quite honest, this is a much more better episode than Celia Fendel, even though that episode had nothing to do with embarrassment. Bottom line is, Carlotta gets an invitation with Elisa, who is a famous singer, and not only that, the Casagrandes got tickets to come along, which leads to Carlotta being desperate to not embarrass herself with her family in front of her favorite idol. To be quite honest, we've all been in this scenario before, and judging how the other characters are portrayed similar to the Loud sisters from the Loud House, I'm starting to convince that even with this family, they're still unstable and dysfunctional, but not in the same way as the Loud House family. But since that this show is also good at character development, if you're interested in the Casagrandes, Carlotta in this episode is probably like Lowy from the Loud House, but on the other hand, I really feel like that her character isn't supposed to be taken seriously, unlike Lowy, who has, let's just say, a mixed fan base of people who enjoy her, but some people still have a grudge towards her in the earlier seasons. With her character trying to be good in front of popular people like Anissa, I really feel like the whole entire family's desperation on being a famous celebrity is similar to the episode where the Loud sisters are mostly obsessed with Hugh. And considering that Bobby has a crush on Anissa, it's no surprise that neither Bobby or Lowy can have one crush in their entire lives. Then again, every single character from this show and the Loud House aren't free from hatred when it comes to their issues. Believe me when I say this, the more I think about this, the more I can understand how toxic the Loud House and the Casagrandes fan bases are. But I'm not really that surprised. Anyway, I really felt like that this show is mostly mistreated for the fact that the characters are still different from the family from the Loud House. And whether you could look at the characters that get a focus, especially in this episode really feels a lot more harmless and a lot more good in its own way, especially with the other episodes in this compared to the Loud House. And considering that Carlotta is regretful for shutting her family down so that she can focus on her interview with Elisa, to be quite honest, everyone who was in this situation before would still do the same thing, even if they're trying to put all their focus on the concert that is going to be happening real soon with one of their favorite idols when it comes to music. Even though that this formula can still work with the Loud House characters, I really feel like that the episodes that this show has similar plots with the Lau House, I can guarantee you that there's going to be possibly more ideas for me to compare one of the episodes from this that has a specific theme or a plot and compare it to a Lau House episode that had that similar plot or theme. To be quite honest, I'm pretty sure that people really wanted to see a versus video or more with one of the episodes from both shows. And with the ending of this, I'll Be There For You, which is actually a good song even for this episode alone, I really feel like that this, along with the wires behind it, took inspiration from one of the issues of one of the worst Lau House episodes and make them much more better. And to be quite honest, I can easily tell what this show is trying to do when it comes to nearly everything else. Granted, this show isn't perfect, but at the same time, it's a hidden gem even as a spin-off. In all honesty, if I'm ever going to get back to the show, aside from the holiday reviews, it's definitely going to be a comparison video of one of the episodes from this and comparing it to one of the episodes from the Lau House. And believe it or not, there was actually plenty of ideas. I'm giving this episode a 7.5 out of 10.